Father Rudy.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
First of all, I would like to praise Almighty Lord for giving us this very happy, happy moment greeting of my sister and Liam. You know, I was nervous because this is my first time to deliver an English speeches. But of course, I try my best. A while ago, Nancy and Liam made their speeches reading in a piece of paper. I thought, it's not allowed, but I make advance. So I make an apology to all of you here if I deliver not in proper permission of my English version. Hello. In behalf of my parents who have passed away years ago, and being the eldest of 9 brothers and sisters of Nancy, I leave my relatives to travel 1,000 miles to go to Scotland upon the invitation of my beloved, very guapo Bayao, brother-in-law, and my sister. Anyway, thank you for coming to us to celebrate this occasion. My family from the Philippines, and of course, the family of my brother-in-law, Liam. You know, I prepare a little special, perhaps if you don't mind, I will agree. Can I?
Yeah.
Where is mine? As I've seen, I'm the eldest brother who led my relatives to hands over the hands of Nancy to my beloved brother-in-law Liam. I'm Rudy Villanueva, the eldest among the 9 members of the family. I have to give my first ever English Scottish brother of the bride speech. Although I promised to Nancy to give a speech, I feel a bit nervous. At first, I forgot the cake that Nancy given me into. She wanted me to fly over than 1,000 miles away to give a speech before people I have never been seen ever before. As if speaking before in a crowd not every enough, she wanted me to speak in English. But being a brother is a great of a great sister, I said, okay. So I may recall that English word I have ever learned in my life to write in speech, but the easily part I get to write I down and read it to you, all of you, the fact that speech was in English as a relief. Imagine if Liam was a prince or German. Please let me start congratulating the newlywed Liam and Nancy. And on behalf of our family, I would also like to thank everyone here for being here and sharing the memorable life ever with the thank you to friends and relatives of you from around the world for Liam and Nancy. The fact truth is Nancy did not do well academically, but on the subject of money, she knows all about it and is terrible. The best part is she knows how to share her blessing, and I thank her for all the help she has given me to the apartment, to the member of his family in the Philippines. I also thank Liam for being hospitality given to us within 2 weeks I stay here. Thank you, Liam, for the whiskey every afternoon. I have been married for more than 40 years. Is my one and only wife. We share. Hello. We have 8 children. 8 boys. The other one. No boy. We have been through ups and downs, but no matter what, the road. I'm sorry. We manage to make it through as one whole family. And the secret is no secret at all, love and trust to each one another. Love together and always strive to the bitter for each other. Sometimes love is not looking at each other face to face, but looking together in the same direction. On behalf of everyone in our family, we welcome you, Liam, a part of our family. Thank you. And we love to find your chapter in both of your lives. May it be filled with happiness and joy. To Liam and Nancy, thank you for inviting us tonight. As to Scotland and giving us a warm welcome to your home. To Nancy, take care of your husband. Give him the trust and confidence, love forever and ever. Support him in all his endeavor. To Liam, please take care of Nancy. And with that, I would like you to have everyone raise your glass as we greet Liam and Liam. Have a great day and a good evening to our peace and everyone.
Just not that emotional today. Welcome, everyone. Firstly, on behalf of Mrs. Torrance and I, I tell you what a relief not having to say I'm trying to pronounce Nancy's surname anymore. Vaughan Weaver, Vanilla Weaver, Vaughan Weaver. I'm not really sure. I think that was one of my top 10 reasons to get married. We'd like to thank all our friends and family for being with us today. People have come from so far and wide, as far as 7,000 miles away in the Philippines, America 4,000 miles away, London 500 miles away, and even Mark Kinch 1,000 miles away. A big thank you to our ushers, Matt, Ryan, Harris, and Keelan for all their help. Thank you to the bridesmaids, Caitlin, Danica, Sheila, Jasmine. All the many maids of honour, here we go. Amelia, Christy, Elvie, Alice, Sophie. I am sure everyone would agree that all of you are beautiful tonight. Thank you to the flower girls from Nine Bears, Sky, Lacia, Kelsey, Caitlin, Aaron, Adam. For my first toast, I'd like to toast the bridesmaids and the wedding party. So if you already have the glasses ready, to the bridesmaids and the wedding party. A special thank you to Damien for doing all the bridesmaids' hair and makeup. Tirelessly today. Worked very hard. All the bridesmaids and maids of honour looked amazing. I would personally like to give a very big thank you to two very important people in my life who have done so much for me and so many others. Unfortunately, one of them I don't think is here tonight, Angela. With all my heart, I thank you. I'll thank Angela anyway, and Mary for everything you have done for me. You know all the reasons why. Thank you. To Davina, who looked after me for so many years whilst I was trying to find Nancy. Thank you. To my brother and best man, Matthew. Especially now that he's offered to pay my bar bill tonight, so I'll be buying plenty of rounds. I would like to thank everyone else that I've not mentioned today, who has helped to make this thing possible, especially Nancy, who has done so much, including doing all the flower arrangements herself. I would love to say I worked very hard as well, but I had a very short and simple list to work to. I'll read my list of instructions that Nancy gave me. One, make sure you're there on time. Two, don't drink too much before the wedding. Well, I'm here on time. Absent friends and family. We are truly blessed to share this day with so many of you. But unfortunately, it's not been possible to have everyone we love here with us today. We know they're here with us in spirit, and not only in our thoughts today, but more importantly, they're always within our hearts. I know we are joined here today with some of our loved ones in spirit. Nancy's mum and dad, Esteban and Lolita. My nan and papa, my uncle Stuart and my uncle Matt. So with them in mind, this brings me to my second toast. Would you please all stand and raise your glasses? And join me in a toast to absent friends and family. To absent friends and family. Thank you. Papa Jimmy once told me when I was about 17 years old, there's nothing better in this world than a good woman's son. That always stuck with me, as did everything else he told me. But it never really made any sense. Now that I'm 44 years old, I met Nancy, I've discovered it was right after all. I thank him for the influence he continues to have in my life. Nancy's family have been living with us for some time, and so far it's been a pleasure, except for a couple of strange moments. First one has been woken up at 3 a.m. Now bear in mind, our neighbour's house was just broken into a couple of weeks before. Woken up at 3 a.m. with a huge banging noise downstairs. I thought somebody was trying to get into the house with a hammer. I rushed down, half asleep, to see the back of someone with a jacket and a balaclava hat on, swinging the largest meat cleaver ever, where lumps of bone and flesh were flying across the kitchen. The man turned around and said, "Good morning, brother, would you like something to eat?" I decided to go and change my underwear. We also had a rice delivery recently. With the size and number of bags of rice that came in, I was sure we would get the winter cold delivery. Now, we have rice for breakfast, rice for lunch, rice for dinner, rice for supper. And if you fancy a snack at any other time, you can have another weird thing called sticky rice. Apparently, it's tradition in the Philippines to give the father of the bride some money and maybe a couple of goats and some chickens. As Nancy's father is no longer with us, I had to negotiate a deal with Nancy's brother Rudy. The final deal agreed didn't give me too much confidence, to be fair, as Nancy cost me a total of 100 cigarettes and a bottle of wine. My brother also blessed us by saying, "Good luck." Now on to my beautiful wife, Nancy. As we all know, life can be challenging and difficult sometimes, but with Nancy by my side, all the difficult times are so much easier. I think one of the best things we could do is laugh, and with Nancy, hardly a day goes past without us laughing. Usually at Nancy, though. I've always gotten a laugh with Nancy's version of the English language. For example, the other day, Nancy said to me about wearing her slipper and on the Facebook, "I need to phone the bagpipe." Which I replied, "Would you not be better calling the guy that plays the bagpipes?" Yesterday, Nancy said, "I phoned the cake today." I said, "The cake can take phone calls, that explains why it's so bloody expensive." I was listening to Nancy from another room recently, I found myself and Danica, Nancy's daughter. And all I heard, and I will keep swearing, I'll keep the swearing out of this for the sake of the children, "That's a stupid kilt. How is anyone expected to fit this bleak kilt? We need a new bleak kilt. It takes ages to fit this kilt. The kilt is upside down. There's no way to get this bleak kilt flat. This kilt is bleeping useless." The swearing and frustration from Nancy got the better of the two of us. So now myself and Danica went along to see what's going on. "Nancy, darling, that's a kilt, not a kilt." Nancy, it's something you want to be a wee bit racist. Nancy loves her food so much, as do all Filipinos, and gets irritated if she gets too hungry. She was away for a few hours one night visiting friends, and on her return, she was irritated, and in the fridge, she kept the food out. while mumbling away under her breath. I said, "What's wrong, darling?" She said, "Bloody white people, they don't beat you." Joking aside now, and it's true. Nancy, you look absolutely stunning today. I want everyone here to know how lucky I feel to be here right now. Nancy's beautiful, funny, caring, great cook, list is endless. They say you don't marry someone you can live with, you marry the person you can't live without. And I think that sums us up perfectly. Nancy, I love you in so many ways and for so many reasons. Because you know me and understand me like no one else ever could. Because you believe in my dreams and care about my feelings. Because you make me laugh so hard and smile so often. Because you have a way of bringing out the very best in me, but mostly because you're my very best friend. I love you with all my heart. Thank you for marrying me and making me the happiest man ever and for loving me as much as I love you. I know this is the start of many, many happy years together. So ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for the most important toast of my life today. To my wife, my bride, my absolute world, to Nancy. Mahal ki to Nancy. One more page. Just one more quick story. And I know I'm going to get in trouble for telling you this because I was born an inch of my life. Don't dare mention it along with this where it was. My sister Pauline, over here, was telling me a wee funny story. Because no one in her family has ever had a humanist wedding before. She decided to Google it and see what it was all about. But she couldn't remember exactly what it was called and typed in naturist. Just to find lots of pictures of making people get married. It's fair for me to clear she'll not be doing that. Now, before I hand over to my brother and my best man, Matthew, here, it's worth mentioning that he actually lives in some kind of weird fantasy world, which causes him to invent stories. He really does believe these stories are true, even his weekly therapist says it's better just let him believe. So if you just humour him during the speech, that would be great, but remember most of the things he says, it's just made up. Thank you everyone. Please enjoy the rest of our day and evening together. Thank you. Wow, he's meant to say two words. What is that all about? Well, anyway, we'll go with this speech. Ladies and gentlemen, for those who don't know me, my name is Matthew and I'm the best man. Back in 2012, I asked him to be my best man and honestly thought I would never have to repay the favour. This being the first time I've been asked to be a best man, I was a little worried how long the speech should last, so I asked around and the general conception was it should last as long as it takes the groom to make love, so thank you all very much. And luckily, Liam has a wee blue tablet in it. For a special occasion like today, it's customary for the best man to perform some duties, so for a start, I'd like to thank the bridesmaids, who all look lovely today and did a fantastic job, except for when you get the photos done and they all disappeared. I actually overheard the girls having a quiet, heated argument earlier about who was going to get the first dance with me. Ladies, one of you is going to have to do it. Ladies and gentlemen, can I ask you please raise your glasses and be upstanding for the bridesmaids. Such The praise base. There's also another note, but no man should look more handsome than a groom, so I'd like to thank Pastors Ryan and Matt for sticking to that role. More importantly, Nancy, you are such a goddess bride and looking stunning today. I think we all agree Liam is punching well up, obviously. I'm just going to add that, and this isn't about, you know, well done with this all. That was so nice. As the best man, it was my job to get Liam here in one piece. I did just that. We were in bed for 11 last night and he slept like a baby. Went to bed once, up for a ball twice. Liam, you're leaving here today with a wife who is warm, caring and beautiful. Nancy, you're leaving here today with a beautiful dress and a bunch of flowers. So, I'll give you a bit of background on Liam. For those who don't really know him, Liam can be described as a caring, loving and protective little brother. Bill. A while back I phoned Liam his mobile, to which he didn't answer as usual. So I left him a voicemail saying, I was trapped in a can upside down, and I failed. 2 weeks later he called me back to check that I got the karaoke. And I know that if I need to call Liam, I call him from Carol's mobile. He answers instantly. Liam has done some advancing stuff over the years, but unfortunately 90%, probably 99%, is not for public consumption. There was the time when he opened the water tanks and cut off the whole water supply to the whole of Largs, or the time he thought it would be a good idea to swallow a 2 pence piece. Quickly realising it wasn't such a good idea and drinking water from the drainpipe to wash it down. I'm sure that's how he learned to polish off a bottle of Jura in, say, 30 minutes, actually 20 minutes. Instead of doing a traditional upper hand gag at this point, I thought I'd give you both some advice. Always remember to tell your wife 3 important little words. You're right, darling. Nancy, a husband is like a tile floor. Lay it right the first time, you can walk all over it for years. Liam, the best way to remember your anniversary is to forget it. Keep the fights clean and sexy dirty. Not sex dirty. Also, Liam, I'd like to thank you for the £400 drinks bill me and Carol woke up to the day after our wedding. If ever will be returned tonight. Boys. What room are you in? 305, guys. May your love may your love be modern enough to service the times of old, passionate enough to last forever. Here's to love, laughter and happily ever after as Liam and Nancy start their new life together. Please stand and toast the new Mr. and Mrs. Torrance. Mr. and Mrs. Torrance. And that's me done, thank God.
I'm going to hand you over to Caitlin and Danica, Nancy's 2 daughters.
As we come here together today, let us tell how our story began. It began with the smell and the beautiful face of a lady that we call Mum. She met a man called Liam who worked for the angels above, and as they laughed and talked, they quickly fell in love. She brought him home to meet us, this special man in our life. Then one day he whisked her away and asked her to be his wife. So here we are today, as three became four, then one, for this is not the ending, it's only just begun. A new life for us all, to love and to share, and two beautiful parents that we will, who will always be there. Always be there to help in life, our lovely new stepdad and our mum, his wife.
This is a song for you. Welcome to